Following your communication a few minutes ago, let me make my exit speech as I hand over the instruments of the office of the leader of majority party to the new office holder. Indeed, just like the famous Swahili saying that kilicho kuwa na mwanzo hakikosi kuwa na mwisho. Today marks the end of my service as the first leader of majority party of this House under Article 108 of the Constitution. Honourable Speaker, to this end, I wish to thank the President of the Republic of Kenya and my party leader, Honourable Uhuru Kenyatta, the Deputy President, His Excellency William Ruto, and the entire Jubilee Party, including the Members of Parliament, for having given me the opportunity to serve the people of Kenya as the leader of majority for the past 7 years now. Mr. Speaker, I also take this opportunity to again thank my colleagues from the minority party, those in the 11th Parliament led by my late brother, Honorable Nyenze, Honorable Jacobo Midio, and the current leadership led by my very, very good friend and a man we joined Parliament together in the 10th Parliament, Honorable Bandi, and Honorable Mbui, who is a deputy. I also take this opportunity to again congratulate my able successor, the Honourable Amos Kimunya, as he takes over the office of the leader of Majority Party in the August House. Honourable Speaker, I know he has a wealth of experience, having served as a Minister for Finance and held various leadership positions in Parliament, and for this, I have no doubt in my mind that he has what it takes. Honourable Kimunya, I wish you all the best. I wish you all the best in your new appointment, and again, congratulations. Honourable Speaker, I have read many comments and views about what Kenyans are saying, that my shoes are too big to fit. This is not, however, for me to judge. All I know is that we wear different shoes, we walk differently, and we feel different in them. As you take up the new mantle, my distinguished colleague, Honorable Kimunya, please wear your shoes, walk according to your style and how you feel. All that counts is that you serve the people of this great nation well. Honorable Speaker, my experience as a leader of majority taught me that as one pushes the agenda of the majority party, it is almost inevitable that one will make new friends, new enemies, and opponents, particularly within the party, depending on where their interests are. Interestingly, interests also keep evolving, and hence, one's opponents today might be his or her friends tomorrow, and vice versa. The most important thing is, while attempting to work with everyone, keep your eye off the ball and deliver the prize. Honorable Speaker, on that note, allow me to unconditionally ask for forgiveness and apologies to anyone in this House and outside who I may have offended in the course of executing my duties. I was simply doing my job. I was simply doing my job. And such is the nature of the job, as Honorable Kimunya will come to appreciate soon. Honorable Speaker, during the 7 years of my service, I came to appreciate the professionalism of the technical staff of Parliament. Your office, Mr. Speaker, the office of the Clerk of the National Assembly, previously held by the late Justin Bundi, and now Mr. Michael Sialai, made my work less difficult. For this, I will forever be grateful, indebted to those officers and the very hard-working men and women who contributed to making the work got done effectively, efficiently, and with speed. Asanteni sana. Mr. Speaker, Honorable Speaker, as I exit, I am indeed proud to know that during my helm as the leader of majority, I was able to push through the agenda of the majority party effectively. The results are out there, and they speak for themselves. And hence, I will not belabor to lay out the same. I was not removed for inefficiency or lack of delivery, but simply the circle of the career of politicians. I therefore harbor no ill feelings or grudge. Honorable Speaker, lastly but not the least, I wish to appreciate my able staff that were drawn from all over the nation. I had incapable members of staff from Nyeri, Laikipia, Kisii, Nyanza, Garissa, among many other counties. I wish them all the best, and I will forever remain indebted for the support they accorded to me the last 7 years. Honorable Speaker, as I conclude, allow me to inform my brother, Honorable Kimunya, that during the transition period, he is also free to consult me on anything. I indeed look forward to being of assistance to him as he settles into his new position. It's not my wish to let him grapple in darkness. Honorable Speaker, I want to thank all the members of Parliament, those who are in the 11th Parliament, who are here, and those who are outside, and those who are in the 12th Parliament, for the invaluable support they gave me during my tenure, and I will always be appreciative of the support they gave me. Honorable Speaker, I want to thank the various directorates in Parliament, the Director of Legal Service and her staff, the Director of Budget, Budget Office and her staff, the Director of Legislative and Procedure, and the Director General. All these together, I want to thank them for the support they gave to my office. Let me say this prayer that is found in Islam, that there's no storm that God won't carry you through. There's no bridge that God won't help you cross. There's no battle that God won't help you win. Trust God and never give up. Amen. Honorable Speaker, finally, and before I retreat to the backbench to serve the great people of Garissa Township, who elected me 3 times in 3 different political parties. ODM brought me to this house, and I want to thank that party. It's the party that inducted me into politics. And in 2013, they elected me under the United Republican Party. And in 2017, they elected me under the Jubilee Party. That alone shows that the people of Garissa Township elect the person, not the party. And they elect the person because of nothing but service delivery. And I'm sure, Mr. Speaker, as now as senior backbench, when I put my card, you'll give me a fair opportunity. You'll give me a fair opportunity as a ranking member to ask questions, to file statements, to file petitions, to join those who were singing during the VAT of 2018, and to join any other group who will be agitated on behalf of the people of Kenya. Speaker, when that comes, I want every member to count on me, because when you are the leader of majority, there are a number of things, and I'm sure my honorable colleague, the leader of minority himself, there are a number of things that you cannot do. But I think the remaining 2 years will help me get so many friends at the backbench. So if you see me with a statement, not only on behalf of the people of Garissa Township, but on behalf of the people of Kenya, you see me with a question, you see me interrogating the executive, and I am sure I am up to the task to exercise the oversight, the representation, the budget making, and the legislative powers given to me by the Constitution on behalf of the people of Garissa Township. I want to tell the people of Garissa Township that I will remain the first occupant of the Leader of Majority office, and I'm sure maybe the longest, for now the longest. In 2013, there were many majority leaders, there were many minority leaders, but I happen to be the longest. 7 years is not a short period. And I am sure I wish those who will come after me, including Honorable Kimunya, that today you will find an office that has the necessary infrastructure, an office that has the capacity, an office that has the linkage with all arms of government. I want to thank, Mr. Speaker, if you allow me, finally, the Office of the Attorney General, the State Law Office, both the former AG, Professor Gidi Mugai, who I've worked very closely with, and the current AG, former Court of Appeal Judge Kihara. I want to thank all the Cabinet Ministers and Principal Secretaries, and those who are in the Executive and in the Judiciary, who in the 7 years we worked together to make sure that there are issues, and the issues of the Executive has been brought to the floor of the House. Finally, Mr. Speaker, as I retreat to the backbench, allow me to hand over this file to the incoming Leader of Majority as his starter pack. It includes, among other things, a brief dealing with the pending business in the House and the majority party business that originated in this House but is now pending in the Senate. The pending business in the pack includes bills by the majority party, which is from the Executive, bills of committees and private members, motions, sessional papers, treaties, among other things. I hope that this symbolic handover becomes part of the practice of the House. Mr. Speaker, this includes my handing over letter, and I want to make it on record and be part of the record of the Hansard that I am handing over bills undergoing mediation, bills passed by the National Assembly and pending in the Senate, bills awaiting second reading, bills awaiting first reading, bills awaiting processing for publication, bills which have been withdrawn, pending treaties, protocols and agreements, sectional papers, private members' bills, and any other business. If you allow me, Mr. Speaker, as I take my seat as a backbencher, let me hand over this file to Honorable Kimunya and ask him to come and take the seat that I have warmed for the last 7 years, and I wish him all the best.
Well, very well. As you exchange the seats, you've already been thanked by the speakership for the diligent work that you've done for the last 7 years, but most importantly, for the magnanimity in your